time for the last talk of the session, which would be on federated SparkQL query processing with replicated fragments. Gabriela Montoya. No? Oh, sorry.
From the University of Nantes. I will present our paper, Federated SparkQL Query Processing with Replicated Fragments. SparkQL endpoints allow to consume linked data using SparkQL query language. The main problem with public endpoints is availability. Recent studies show that only 32.2% of public endpoints can expect it to have uptime of 99 to 100%. Availability problem prevents from using linked data in real applications. Traditionally, replication and fragmentation allow to overcome availability problem. For instance, in distributed database, we can fragment are smartly allocated and replicated across server for load balancing and reduce intermediate result. In linked data, we cannot replication and fragmentation cannot be designed because data provider and data consumer are autonomous. So it is not possible to have a tight coordination of data provider. In an ideal world, I would like to have any data provider is able to replicate a subset of any available data. Data replication will allow to reorganize data and will create new localities. These new localities can be used and open the opportunity for query optimization. But today, a replication is not managed in linked data. So how a data provider can declare that she or he replicates data from another data set. If I solve this problem, I will have another one. In fact, if we have new localities, federated query engine cannot take advantage of this new locality because federated query engine is not designed to deal with replication. And in presence of replication, the performance of the federated query engine is decreased. So how a federated engine can take advantage of data locality to speed up queries execution? Now I will show you how federated query engine can handle replication today. For instance, I set up a replication of two replicas of DBpedia, DB1 and DB2. The two replicas are identical. And I want to execute this SparkQL query on the federation of DB1 and DB2. I can use the federated query engine FedEx to execute this query on this federation. FedEx is unaware of the replication of data, so it will contact both SparkQL endpoints to answer this query. And a lot of redundant data will be transferred from the endpoint to the federated query engine, and the final result will be produced by the federated query engine. In this case, the replication decreases the performance of the federated query engine. For instance, with one replica, FedEx will have this execution time. If I have two replica in my federation, the execution time is largely increased. So I need to handle replication in linked data. How we can declare replication in linked data? In general, data consumer will not replicate the whole data set. They will replicate only a fragment of relevant data that is relevant for their needs. For instance, if I am interested in DBpedia, a linked movie DB, I will replicate fragmentum from those endpoints. So I can replicate fragment from DBpedia. In this work, we define fragment as a fragment is described by a data source and a triple pattern. The triple pattern is a construct Sparkle query. The result of this construct is a set of triples, the contenant of the fragment. In the same way, I can replicate another fragment from DBpedia, and I can replicate fragment from LinkedMovieDB. Replication of data from several endpoints allows to create new localities. These localities cannot exist in the original data set. Now, how we can take advantage of this locality, how we can carry in presence of replicated fragments. I will set up a federation of the three endpoints, DBpedia, LinkedMovie, and C1, that contain replicated data from both data set. And I want to execute this query in this federation. I can use a federated query engine as FedEx. If I use FedEx, since FedEx is unaware of data replication, it will select all the data sources in order to answer this query. And as we see, a lot of tables will be transferred from the query from the endpoint to the query engine. And we will have execution time of about 20.22 seconds. Another choice could be to choose only public endpoints. It's better than the previous one, but I still transfer many tables from the endpoint to the federated query engine. Another possible solution is to use the replicated fragment with one of the public endpoints. I will transfer the same number of tables and will have nearly the same execution time. The last possible solution is to use the new locality in order to execute this query. I can use only T1 to execute the query. In this case, I will transfer less table from the endpoint to the federated query engine, and I will have a good execution time. This is the best solution, and I want to develop a source selection strategy that allowed me to find this solution. So I want to propose a source selection for federated query engine with a replicated fragment. The source selection can take advantage of new data locality when possible. If we look to the state of the art, the most relevant work to our problem is DAWO. DAWO is a duplicated aware source selection for federated query engines, and it uses Sketch in order to detect overlapping within data set. And DAWO will perform source selection at level of triple pattern by triple pattern. So DAWO cannot take advantage of the new data locality in order to delegate joins. My scientific problem that I want to answer, given a Sparkle query and a federation of Sparkle endpoints with a replicated fragment, I want to choose Sparkle endpoints to contact in order to have a complete answer of the query and to transfer the minimum amount of data and to delegate join, if possible, to the endpoint. We propose a solution to this problem that we call Fedra. Fedra is a BGB aware source selection. Fedra works in three steps. The first step, Fedra selects relevant fragment per triple pattern and reduce the endpoint using query containment. Second step, for triple pattern with multiple relevant fragment, Fedra will perform union reduction in order to reduce the number of non-common endpoints. Finally, for triple pattern with one relevant fragment, Fedra will perform PGB reduction and reduce the problem to set covering problem. In the following, I will present this algorithm through an example. So the first step, I will show you our federation. I work in this federation. I have fragment replicated from DBBDIA, from linked movie DB. I have a federation of four Sparkle endpoints with replicated fragment. The fragment mapping gives the location of the fragment on the endpoint. For instance, in C1, I have fragment F1, F2, and F4, and et cetera, et cetera. I will work with this federation. I will you illustrate the algorithm on this PGP basic graph pattern. I have four triple patterns, and the first step of Fedora is to select relevant fragment for the PGP. I will start with, for each triple pattern, we will select relevant fragment. In this case, for TP1, we have F1 and F3 that can answer this triple pattern. As we can see, F3 is contained in F1. As you can see, F3 is contained in F1, so I don't need to keep F3 and the endpoint C2. It's enough to have F1 to answer this triple pattern. I continue with for TP2, the relevant fragment F2. I have nothing to do. There's only one fragment. For F4, for TP3, it's 4. And for the last one, for TP4, relevant fragment F5 and F6. And if we look to these two fragments, there is no containment relation between these two fragments. So I need to keep both in order to answer this triple pattern. And with this, I finish the first step of the algorithm. The next step is union reduction. Union reduction is to reduce non-common endpoint for triple pattern with more than one relevant fragment. This is the case of TP4. We have F5 and F6. As we can see, both are available at the endpoint C2. So it's enough to keep C2. We do not need to keep C4 and C3. And we will rename these two fragments by a virtual fragment that I call F prime. We finish union reduction. Now we can execute the last step of the algorithm, BGB reduction. BGB reduction is transform the problem, reduce the problem to the problem of set covering problem. The set I want to cover is TP1, TP2, TP3, TP4. A possible solution to this problem is to use C1 because it covers TP1, TP2, TP3. And we can use C2 because it covers TP3 and TP4. Fedora will produce a solution, C1, which selects C1 and C2 to execute this query. If we use a source selection that makes the source selection at the level of triple as double, we could select another source. It would select C1, C3, and C2 to execute this query. So I can say that Fedora performs a BGB-aware source selection. The knowledge of the fragment replication allow to reduce the selected sources. And since we consider BGB instead of triple pattern, we are able to exploit fragment locality and reduce the number of transfer tuples. Now I finished with the algorithm of Fedora. I will show you our experimental parts. So I start with the setup. We make experimentation with 6 data set. We use 4 data set and 2 synthetic data set with WordDiff, with 2 instances with WordDiff. We load all this data set in the LDF server, and we set up federation with 10 endpoints. For each data set, we set a federation with 10 endpoints, and for each endpoint, we generate 100 random queries. For each query, for each triple pattern of the query, we generate a fragment. These fragments are distributed randomly among the endpoint. Each fragment is replicated up to 3 times. We integrated Fedora with the state of the art federated query engine, FedEx and Elapsid. We replaced the source selection of FedEx with Fedora, the same with Elapsid, and we implemented DAO with FedEx and Elasticsearch in order to compare with our solution. I can represent now our result. Here in the x-axis we have our six federation. In the y-axis we have the number of selected sources, and the box plot represents the result of the execution of 100 queries. These queries are different from those used to generate fragments. As we can see, in all federation, Fedra with Elasticsearch reduce the number of selected sources. And I forget to say that the number of selected sources is the number of sources selected per query. So in all cases, we have good performance. We observe the same thing with FedEx. Also, Fedra with FedEx outperform other solution in the number of selected sources. We select always less sources, and the reduction is up to 400% per query. We measure also the reduction in the number of transfer to. Again, we have six federation, and in the y-axis now we have the number of transfer to, and we run the execution for 100 query. As we can see, also here the result for Fedra with Elasticsearch. As we can see, the Fedra reduce the number of transfer table from the federated from the endpoint to the federated query engine. And this, we observe the same thing with FedEx, where Fedra reduce also the number of transfer to, and the reduction is up to for order of magnitude. Only for this federation with semantic web food, we don't have a good result. Fedra transferred a lot of results, but this is not our mistake. This is because of FedEx. And FedEx make a group of triple better to submit it to the endpoint, and sometimes it can group triple pattern without a common variable, so it will generate a Cartesian product that will produce a lot of intermediate results. One possible solution to this problem is to separate this triple pattern and send it separately to the endpoint. As a conclusion, I can say that I present a way to manage partial replication in linked data using fragments. I present Fedra that perform BGB aware source selection with a dedicated fragment. Fedra take advantage of locality to reduce the number of transfer tables, and it achieve a great reduction in the number of selected sources and number of transfer tables. As a perspective of this work, in this work we worked under the assumption that replicated fragments are perfectly synchronized. So we have read only fragment. We don't have update. If we have update in the fragment and the original data, so we have to integrate metrics to measure the divergence between the selected sources. Another perspective for our work, it's now Fedra is used to reduce the number of selected sources, but does not exploit replicated data to speed up query processing. One possible perspective is to use to share the execution of the subquery among the endpoints that provide the same relevant data. That's all. Thank you for your attention. Any questions?
Thank you.
Any questions? Yes, please.
Français, anglais?
Français, anglais, ça va.
OK. Par rapport aux perspectives, si vous prenez en compte la cohérence des sources, comment vous imaginez gérer éventuellement des objectifs contradictoires entre la localité et la cohérence des données?
Oui, ça veut dire que vous voulez qu'on ajoute un peu plus de sémantique.
Ah, imaginons que la source qui est proche, les données ne sont pas fraîches, alors qu'une plus éloignée, les données sont fraîches.
Alors, ouais, mais ça dépend après de notre métrique, ça fait partie des métriques qu'on peut définir. Après, est-ce que dans ma métrique, je vais prendre le plus fraîche, le plus...
C'est justement la question, c'est comment vous allez gérer ces objectifs contradictoires? Qu'est-ce qui va être privilégié? Pas d'idée pour l'instant.
Non, on a travaillé un peu, mais nous, ça dépend des métriques. Alors, est-ce que je prends...
Vu que c'est sur les perspectives, c'est à la limite pas problématique. C'est de savoir s'il y avait déjà des idées pour traiter ce genre de problème.
On a travaillé des fois sur on prenait le timestamp. C'était une des idées qu'on a développées. On a travaillé un peu là-dessus pour voir est-ce que prendre le plus récent, le moins récent, ou peu importe la taille des changements. Est-ce que je prends là où il y a plus de changements, moins de changements? Ça, c'est aussi parmi des métriques qu'on a pensé à utiliser. Tout à fait.
D'accord, ouais. Merci.
Another question? Okay, then thank you very much again.